central nervous system. The nervous tissue present in the central axis of the body constitutes central nervous system. Example, brain and spinal cord. Brain. The parts of the brain are cerebrum, cerebellum and the brainstem. So the parts of the brain are cerebrum, cerebellum and the brainstem. The brainstem includes midbrain, pons and medulla oblongata. Cerebrum. It is the largest part of the brain. Situation. It is situated in the cranium, in the anterior and middle cranial fossae. So this is the skull, okay, the cranium. I have opened the cranium. See, this is the cranium you have. This is the anterior cranial fossa. This is the middle cranial fossa. And this is the posterior cranial fossa. The cerebrum is situated in the anterior and middle cranial fossa. The posterior cranial fossa lodges the cerebellum. General features. The cerebrum consists of two cerebral hemispheres separated in the midline by a gap or a fissure known as median longitudinal fissure. Median longitudinal fissure. The depth of the median longitudinal fissure, the two cerebral hemispheres are connected by commissural fibers known as corpus callosum. So this is a corpus callosum. So through this, the two cerebral hemispheres are connected. Each cerebral hemisphere has three poles: frontal pole, occipital pole and temporal pole. Once I repeat, each cerebral hemisphere has three poles, that is ends: frontal pole, occipital pole and temporal pole. Three borders: superomedial border, inferomedial border and inferolateral border. Superomedial border, inferomedial border and inferolateral border. Three surfaces: superolateral surface, medial surface and inferior surface. The surface of the cerebrum has a number of grooves and elevations. The grooves are known as sulci, singular sulcus, and the elevations are known as gyri and singular gyrus. Okay. I'm going to state some of the important sulcus. Okay, this is the central sulcus. It is a groove present in the center of the frontal and the occipital pole. Between these two poles, if you take the center point, so this is the central sulcus. Okay. Number two, lateral sulcus. Okay, lateral sulcus. So the cerebrum is divided into lower part and upper part by this groove. I'll tell the parts later. Okay. Third one is parieto-occipital sulcus. This is the parieto-occipital sulcus. Actually, it is very prominent on the medial surface. Okay. So a small part is coming on the superolateral surface. So these are the important sulci. Okay. Lobes of the cerebrum. Each cerebral hemisphere has four lobes: frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe and temporal lobe. Number one, frontal lobe. The area of the cerebrum present anterior to the central sulcus constitutes frontal lobe. Parietal lobe. The area of the cerebrum present between the central sulcus and the parieto-occipital sulcus. So this area constitutes the parietal lobe. Occipital sulcus lobe. Occipital lobe. Okay, it is a part of the cerebrum present behind the parieto-occipital sulcus. Temporal lobe. It is a part of the cerebrum present below the lateral sulcus. So the lateral sulcus separates the temporal lobe from the frontal and parietal lobes. The frontal and parietal lobe are above the lateral sulcus. The temporal lobe is below the lateral sulcus. Important functional areas. Okay, that is functional areas of cerebrum. What are the functional areas of cerebrum? Number one, primary motor area. I already told you this is the central sulcus. Okay, so this is the area where the primary motor area is situated. Primary motor area, it is present in the precentral gyrus. Precentral, before, okay, pre means in front. Central, that is the central sulcus. Okay, gyrus means elevation. So this is the elevation present in front of the central sulcus. So this is the precentral gyrus. So primary motor area, it is present in the precentral gyrus. Primary somatostatic area or primary sensory area, this is the area. So it is present in the post central gyrus. So behind the central sulcus there is an elevation, that is known as post central gyrus. So it is present in the post central gyrus. Okay, it receives the sensation from the one side of the body. Primary visual area, it is present in the occipital lobe. It is present in the occipital lobe near the occipital pole. This area, okay, this part near the occipital pole, it is present. Primary auditory area. Okay, so you can see three gyrus in the temporal lobe: superior temporal gyrus, middle temporal gyrus, and inferior temporal gyrus. In the superior temporal gyrus, okay, see, deep to the lateral sulcus, if you separate on the superior surface of the superior temporal gyrus, the primary auditory area is present. So primary auditory area, it is present in the superior surface of the superior temporal gyrus. Motor speech area of Broca's. Okay, this is the central sulcus. In front of the central sulcus, this is the frontal lobe. Already you have seen the primary motor area. So near the lower end of the primary motor area, see where I am touching this area. Okay, this is the superior frontal gyrus, this is the middle frontal gyrus, and this is the inferior frontal gyrus. So motor speech area, Broca's area of speech, it is present in the frontal lobe. Which part? Inferior frontal gyrus. It is situated in the inferior frontal gyrus of the frontal lobe, near the lower end of the precentral gyrus or the primary motor area, just in front of the primary motor area. Sensory speech area or Wernicke speech area, it is present in the, see, this is superior temporal gyrus, middle temporal gyrus, inferior temporal gyrus. Near the posterior end of the superior temporal gyrus, okay, it is present. So sensory speech area of Wernicke's, it is present in the posterior end of the superior temporal gyrus and adjoining inferior part of the parietal lobe So these are the some of the important functional areas. So one sign I will going to explain in the board. Okay, as you see, primary motor area, this is the central sulcus. Primary motor area, it is present in the precentral gyrus. It controls the entire motor activity of one half of the body. There is one side of the body. Okay. Primary somatostatic area. It receives the entire sensation from the one side of the body. It is present in the postcentral gyrus. Primary visual area. It is present in the occipital lobe near the occipital pole. Near the occipital pole. Primary auditory area. It is present in the superior temporal gyrus, but near its superior surface. So on the superior surface of the superior temporal gyrus, the primary auditory area is present. Motor speech area of Broca's. It is present in the frontal lobe. So it is situated in the inferior frontal lobe of the inferior frontal gyrus of the frontal lobe. Inferior frontal gyrus of the frontal lobe, anterior to the primary motor area. Sensory area of speech, that is larynx area of speech, it is present in the posterior end of the superior temporal gyrus, posterior end of the superior temporal gyrus, and adjoining inferior part of the parietal lobe, and adjoining inferior part of the parietal lobe. Secondary motor area or premotor area. So this is the secondary motor area or premotor area. Okay, it is present in the frontal lobe, anterior to the primary motor area. Anterior to the primary motor area. Number two, okay, secondary sensory area or associated sensory area. Okay, it is present in the parietal lobe. This area is the parietal lobe, okay, behind the primary somatostatic area or sensory area. So where it is present in the parietal lobe? Okay, secondary sensory area is situated in the upper part of the parietal lobe, upper part of the parietal lobe, behind the primary somatostatic area. So this is secondary sensory area. Secondary visual area, it is present in the occipital lobe surrounding the primary visual area. It is present in the occipital lobe surrounding the primary visual area. So this is the secondary visual area. Secondary auditory area. See, it is present in the superior temporal gyrus. See, the primary motor area is also present in the superior temporal gyrus, but it is present in the superior surface of the superior temporal gyrus. The secondary auditory area is situated on the lateral surface of the superior temporal gyrus. Lateral surface of the superior temporal gyrus. So this is the secondary motor area or premotor area. This is the secondary sensory area. Okay, and this is the secondary visual area, and this is the secondary auditory area. So these are the functional areas of cerebrum. White matter of cerebrum, fibers of the cerebrum. So the white matter of the cerebrum contains myelinated fibers. So the fibers of the cerebrum are classified into three types. Number one, associated fibers. Number two, commissural fibers. Number three, projection fibers. A, C, P. Associated fibers, commissural fibers, and projection fibers. What are associated fibers? They interconnect different regions present in the cerebral cortex of the same hemisphere. It is of two types: short association fibers and long association fibers. Short association fibers connect adjacent gyri. So they connect the adjacent gyri. Arcuate fibers, example, arcuate fibers. Long association fibers, they connect widely separated gyri, for example, from this gyrus to this gyrus, from this gyrus to this gyrus, or from this gyrus to this gyrus. So it connects the widely separated gyri. So this is the associated fibers. Okay. Next one is commissural fibers. Okay. They interconnect identical areas of the cerebral cortex present in two different hemispheres. See, association fibers connect the different regions present in same cerebral hemispheres, whereas the projection fibers connect identical areas present in two cerebral hemispheres. Example, corpus callosum. So present in this cerebral hemisphere and this is the corpus callosum. So they interconnect. So this is the one of the commissural fiber. Number two, anterior commissure. Number three, posterior commissure. Number four, habenular commissure. Number five, hippocampal commissure. So these are the commissural fibers present in the cerebrum. That is a white matter or white fibers. Okay, now fibers present in the cerebrum. And the last one is projection fibers. See, the projection fibers, they interconnect the cerebral cortex with subcortical areas or spinal cord. Subcortical areas, for example, from the primary motor area to the subcortical area means to the thalamus or midbrain, pons, middle obligata, or the spinal cord. So that is a, so from this cerebral cortex to subcortical areas or spinal cord. So these type of fibers are known as projection fibers. Example, internal capsule, corona radiata, fimbria, and fornix. So there are three types of fibers: associated fibers, commissural fibers, and projection fibers. Associated fibers connects the gyrus present in the same hemisphere. Commissural fibers connects the two cerebral hemispheres. Projection fibers from the cerebral cortex to the subcortical area or the spinal cord.